without and to that extent, I take also this opportunity to welcome our keynote address speaker, Mr. Macdonald Obudho, who is the Director General for Kenya National Bureau of Statistics, to give us a keynote address at that point. Thank you very much and welcome, sir.
Wow. Thank you so much, Bwana CEO, for the chance. I'm in an area where my network might not be very good, so I'm not sure if I'll be able to display my video because of the network challenges. I hope you are able to hear me.
Yes, we can hear you very well, and you can proceed. Don't worry about the videos if the connectivity is not good.
Thank you so much. Yes, I'm somewhere in Machakos, and I think I'm really struggling to have that network keeping me on until the end. I'm not very sure. Maybe at some point you might be losing me, but let me take this chance this morning to say hi to all the participants, starting from the CEO, Clifford Okembo. Well, the CEO, we have been interacting so much with your team in a number of areas. All the participants who are here, both from the government and non-government, from Kenya and from East Africa, the whole of Africa, I've noted that there are also participants who have joined outside from outside Africa. Good morning to all of you. It could be good afternoon, it could be good evening, depending on where you are. So I'm Macdonald George Obudho, Director General at Kenya National Bureau of Statistics here in Kenya. And actually, I've been privileged to be given a chance today to join you in this conference, which has brought together a number of participants from the region and across the globe. Rarely do people from such a rich, diverse background come together to, in order to share ideas, experiences, and with a view to develop a new agenda for prosperity of this region. So it is a real excitement actually to be part of this kind of a process. I take this early opportunity to sincerely thank the CEO of Esri East Africa for taking the initiative to bring us together with a number of partners in the region to discuss matters of interest. This gathering is actually united, is uniting us for a common purpose that can be summarized as follows. One is to share and have a common picture on the progress and implementation of local locational analytics technology in the region. And two, network with peers, discover emerging trends in the geospatial world, and gain useful insights from the technology and industry experts. And three, test new products, improve technical development skills, and gain new mapping techniques, which will also help in expanding our network and receive invaluable ideas to energize our GIS operations. The theme of the workshop, which is entitled Geographic Information System for Effective and Participatory Governance, really emphasizes on two key issues that are critical to the government. One is the participatory governance, and two is the use of relevant technology. Today, our world, and to an extent, our countries are facing enormous challenges, and it is clear that we need to work together collectively to collectively create a better future. we need to leverage on our very good brains, our best creative talents,
we lost you.
Oh, no, I don't know at what point you lost me.
Talent part.
Pardon?
Challenge.
Challenge part. Okay. Yeah, now. So maybe I could just get back a little bit. But I had tried relating the objectives of this workshop, or what we are doing, and also mentioned that the theme of the workshop, which is geographic information system for effective and participatory governance, really emphasizes on two key issues to the government, which are actually very critical to the government. One of them is the participatory governance, and the second one is the use of relevant technology. I went ahead also to mention that in today's world, and to a great extent, our countries are facing enormous challenges, and it is also clear that we need to work together to collectively create a better future. We need to leverage on our very best brains that we have, our creative talents, our design talents, and the technology that is available, that is actually at our disposal, to together with the science, so that we can use this to create a more sustainable development. So really, we have all that we require to make a better, to have a better future, which is actually sustainable. Now, with these challenges, it is actually what is really important to move us beyond is simply to measure and analyze data to understand and resolve some of the biggest problems facing the world today. So geography is the science of our world, which provides both content and context, as well as a common reference system to help us see some of these complexities, relationships, patterns, and associations. Now, across the world, GIS is already helping us to understand things. It is providing a framework for transforming the world through all kinds of activities. So GIS changes how we think, how and how we act. It is actually a transformational system that we have in today's world. It is also integrating the geographic science into everything that we do. For example, we are able to measure and also help us in analyzing things. We are also able to use it to do predictions, and we are also able to use it to do plans. We also able to use the same kind of technology to design and also evaluate. And of course, beyond that, it is also giving us now a chance to manage our processes over time. Now, mobile GIS enables rapid data exchange between the field teams and the operations centers. Desktop GIS provides an extraordinary ability to manage, analyze, and visualize statistical data of a given area of interest to show patterns, trends, and relationships for effective decision making. Now, online GIS provides an interactive platform to disseminate and share data. So, ladies and gentlemen, the Kenya National Bureau of Statistics, which is a state corporation under the State Department for Planning within the Ministry of National Treasury and Planning, was actually created through an Act of Parliament, and this was in the year 2006. And this act gives us the power to collect, compile, analyze, and publish, and also disseminate statistical information that is required for our planning purposes. We are also responsible for the coordination of the national statistical system and for other connected purposes. One of our key mandates is actually the conduct of population and housing census every 10 years, and any other censuses and surveys that our board of directors would approve from time to time. So now looking at the element of the conduct of a census, Kenya is one country that has always conducted its censuses every 10 years and very, very faithfully on the 24th, 25th night of August every census year. So the last one was no exception. We were able to do it within those dates as required. And there are a number of preparatory activities that would go into it. One of them is actually the cartographic mapping, which is very key. And during that period, we are able we normally come up with a geofile that is created for the whole country. This geofile is used to integrate spatial and statistical data. Our consumers really expect a timely and up-to-date and ready to consume data in a digital format that renders itself to interaction and their spatial analysis. So to that end, the Bureau recognizes the GIS system as a very essential technology for all the stages of the national statistics life cycle. And that starts from the preparation, we go to planning, we go to data collection, we go to data entry and editing, of course, where there is any data entry that is involved, then it goes to dissemination and the documentation of that, of the whole process. So GIS was actually introduced in KNBS way back in 1998, and its use has been greatly improved over the years. So getting back to the census of 2019 used the ArcGIS, both in the field.
It's back.
Sorry, are you able to hear me now?
Yes, you might start from getting back to that statement.
Okay, yeah, so I was just saying that I've tried just connecting some of our operations with the GIS technology, and I picked on the censuses. So I was just mentioning that in the last census that we did in 2019, the Bureau was able to use the ArcGIS both in the field and in the offices to collect and process spatial data. And ArcGIS provided up-to-date data that was used for planning and execution of the exercises. Mobile GIS was used to collect data during the cartographic mapping, and this enabled rapid data exchange between the field teams and the map production team in the office. And we noted that the desktop GIS provided an extraordinary ability to manage, analyze, and visualize demographics of a given area of interest. For example, the population density by counties that displays patterns, trends, and relationships for effective decision making. So going forward, KNBS intends to use online GIS to provide an interactive platform to disseminate and share data. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could just give a little bit of more information concerning how we were able to utilize this technology in our census, and especially during mapping time. Previously, we have been making attempts of ensuring that we go by the latest technology. And as we are now planning for the census, we checked around within Africa to see what other countries have done before. And we noted that some of the countries talking of having conducted the digital censuses, we noted that mapping was actually still manual. But for our case, we insisted as an organization that we want to take a direction that will lead us to having the whole process of census undertaking to be digital. And that had to start with mapping. Now, in this case, we came up with a system. Initially, we were using the ODK to start our mapping. But at one point, we noted that it was not fully digital because certain functionalities had to be done manually. And in which case, then, we would not really take the pride of having done a fully digital census. So we collaborated with ESRI. And ESRI was able to develop for us a system. Actually, it was survey solution 1, 2, 3 to. I'm very sorry for this. Actually, I'm tethering from my phone and calls keep on coming in and that is causing interruption. Sorry, so I was just saying that we were able to get the support from ESRI, and ESRI was able to develop for us a system that was fully automated. So we would be able to get, using the survey 1, 2, 3, we would be able to get data collected very, very well digitally. And we would just use that one on our ArcMap so that we were able to process data immediately. And this was very useful because then it was cutting down on time that would take to process the data generated during mapping. And you know, we are talking of enormous data. You can imagine that we go around every village in the whole country. It is really massive. And so this system that was able to bail us out and have our results coming out in good time. And in the process, it attracted a lot of interest within Africa and beyond. And so far, we have hosted 5 countries to come and learn how we were able to manage these processes. So this is one thing that I would say that has worked very well. My second point on this that I could quickly mention is that there's no boundary. There's no limitation of knowledge. Because what you are venturing into, even ESRI had not done it before. But because of the collaboration we had, we insisted now this thing has to work. And actually, they had to work day and night to provide a solution, and the solution was found. So today, if you are to do anything in the field, we are not starting from zero. We are talking of an automated process that has worked, courtesy of ESRI. So I'm very sure that whatever that is ahead of us, where we need to look into the sustainable future in terms of this kind of technology, I'm very certain that we are talking of something that is very possible, very practical, and we'll be able to achieve it. In devolved governance, local authorities, counties, would face numerous challenges due to the high hopes and expectations of citizens. We have the immediate priorities, which include increased revenue collection, up-to-date spatial plans, pressure on service delivery, effective asset management, participative governance, and project monitoring and evaluation. So all these areas, our devolved governors would really face a lot of challenges with the citizen if they are not moving as fast as possible. So as a result, local authorities or counties are turning to the GIS technology for better planning, management, and decision making, which is actually the way to go. Effective implementation of an integrated GIS system in all government departments will lead to better planning, management, and decision making. It will enable return on investment in local authorities, including reduced operational cost, but increased productivity, and of course revenue collections. Other benefits pertain to increased transparency and accountability, participatory planning, and increased access to government services by citizenry. In elections, for example, easy access to poll information at any one time, involving participation of all stakeholders, would lead to higher voter turnout and confidence in the election results finally when they are announced. The integration of the GIS technology with other technologies have been applied in election cycles from voter registration to the declaration of election results, which really enable effective and effective election management. Now, in health, for example, GIS enables a spatial representation of data to support better public health planning and decision making. Timely access to community health information helps leaders maintain situational awareness, confirm assumptions, and understand community needs. The outbreak of COVID-19 showed that a disease can spread so quickly, and so information has to move even faster. So John Hopkins University launched its COVID-19 dashboard that provided immense information on the spread and management of the pandemic. Currently, GIS is being used to manage COVID-19 vaccination across the globe. And these are some of the good examples that we can mention that this kind of technology really supports, and we need to take it to the next level. So ladies and gentlemen, today we come together here to explore various local applications of GIS in our line of work and for the day-to-day interactions. Let me then share and learn from one another so that we would be able to really improve our lives going into the future, because any improvement we make today would really be useful and will inform what can also be done tomorrow. So once again, colleagues, I would like to welcome you to this conference and wish you a very, very fruitful deliberation. And thank you so much for giving me the chance. Thank you to all.
Great. Thank you so much, Mr. Obudho, for the great presentation.
So maybe when I see you, I could make an attempt of showing my face.
Yes.
That is my face.
It's good people to be sure that you are not talking in a machine.
it was not a robot, it was a human being. And that is me. So I fear using the two because the connectivity here is not very good. And so that's what that was my limitation. But I'm very, very thankful to the organizers of this. When I see you, it is actually going to take us to another level. As I've mentioned, you realize that you and your team, you had to work very hard to meet our demands, which worked well. And we are very proud of the process that you have gone through. And we can always recommend you over and over again. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. We are proud to to be with you and also to partner with you. And thank you very much again for sparing your very busy schedule, because you're actually off the office, offsite for other assignments. So thank you very much. I know that you've talked about very great things, how the system enabled Kenya to actually do their census in time. By the way, Kenya in East Africa, I'm not sure about other countries beyond Africa, Kenya was the first country to hold their first 2020 round of census. I believe now both Uganda and Tanzania working hard to have their censuses next year, if not next year, but one. So thank you so much. Is that allowed, or they'll be handled later?
Maybe you might repeat. We missed you a little bit from, thank you so much.
Ah, okay. I'm just saying, I'm seeing some few questions on the chat, and I'm not sure whether